Welcome on our program here on Sunrise, the Chairman Emeritus of the National Association of Independent Travel Agencies. We have Dr. Robert Lim Joseph. Good morning, Dr. Joseph.
Good morning, partner.
Good morning. I guess this thing is blowing up in our faces again on the international stage, the tourism campaign, which was unceremoniously aborted a day after it was launched. What's wrong with it, as far as you're concerned?
First of all, I just came out from a program, Umagang Kay Ganda, with Secretary Lim.
Yes, he was right beside you.
A few minutes ago, and you know what was sad is he was talking about big campaigns, and when I asked him, by the way, how much is the budget that you have, and he says 200 million pesos.
Right.
Oh my goodness, that's only $4 million.
That's duck soup. Yeah,
you know, that's only for a little cigarette money.
Right.
You don't come up with a campaign as such unless. So you have to maintain the Wow Philippines.
Right.
Because it's too hard. A second is, he had the gall to say that they launched it, but this they'll go through a series. You don't do a launching with the president of the vice president with you, and at the same time bring in 400 tourism stakeholders without having an open forum.
Right.
Because it was a launching.
Okay.
And the third issue, the biggest whammo, is when you say Pilipinas Kay Ganda, it sounds Pilipinas is Filipinas. And Kay Ganda is Filipinas, beautiful. And after the fireworks, they had three girls
on stage. Right, on stage, uh-huh.
On stage. And that comes in YouTube, what happens now is you are selling
Filipino women.
Filipino women. And in YouTube and in the internet, the linkage goes to some porno and
websites,
website of Filipinas and mail order brides. You know, this is getting ridiculous.
So, you're saying it immediately sends the wrong message.
Yes, and you know the problem is they have not gone into consultation. I've talked to him on August 19. I told him, hey, why don't you call us? The problem is, you know, when he took over, he refused to even talk to Secretary Ace Durano, and there was no turnover.
Mm-hmm.
They took out the two top undersecretaries who has been in the industry, one for 35 years, one for 11 years, without any turnover. He just wants to change for the sake of changing.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are a CEO and you don't have a linkage to the past, then how do you act today and for the future? So you're lost.
Yeah, quite honestly, you know, doctor, I'm seeing a pattern here with this government that they just change everything from the past for change's sake. I mean, there was no rhyme or reason. I was just on this program. Dick Gordon was just on with us a few minutes ago, and he was saying that he was working with a budget of about only $680 million. You're saying they're working with a $4 million budget, which according to you is already chump change, but to think that Dick Gordon was working with $680,000, and yet Wow Philippines turned out to be quite a success.
Well, we see. Dick was able to get fundings from to get the support, and today because of the law, they can put in over $1 billion, so $20 million to $40 million. They can raise because you know. There is under the law that was crafted by Senator Dick Gordon.
Mm-hmm.
It gives the Department of Tourism a 20% to 25% of the share that is remitted to the President of the Republic coming from PAGCOR.
Right.
You see, earlier I also asked the Secretary, why are you saying that you don't have a budget? And then, you know, while there was no show, he says, yeah, but you know, that is PAGCOR. I said, come on. Don't tell this is no budget. And then you want to put in 100 million pesos for an internet promotion? Come on. An internet promotion, 100 million, while you want to change our brand? How much is that in CNN?
Right.
And the other thing that if you saw the print, are you doing only print? Are you coming on radio? Are you coming on television?
Yeah, multimedia, yeah.
And if you come on multimedia, how can you account for the Tarsier that you made it into a mascot
yes.
of the Philippines?
On the logo, yes.
Now, what are we, a bunch of monkeys? you see, if you look at Singapore...
I guess they're promoting indigenous animals, right? Animals uniquely Filipino? Or, I don't know, Philippine? I don't know.
Yeah, but you see, you put something funny there. You know, you have to look at it from the point of view of the foreigners.
Right.
Not from a point of view of some people who just want to change for the sake of change.
Right.
So this has to be studied.
Well, that's what I was mentioning too, yeah. I was mentioning doctor, I was mentioning to Dick Gordon that it brings to mind the old adage that if it ain't broke, why fix it? I mean,
correct.
You know.
And then he said that because it was though Dick Gordon used that on the second, the guy did not use it that much. The reason why he did not use it that much and people don't realize, he did not use the CNN, but he did market segmentation by promoting to the direct market. And who are the direct markets? His direct target market was China, Japan, Korea.
Mm-hmm.
So this was the Asian, but basically this is the market. That's why we had a tremendous growth. Because you see, you cannot also promote it in England, in Russia, in Latvia, because we don't have flights there.
True.